Hey guys, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, do-it-yourself dog training, how to place command with a remote collar. We're doing, we love e-collar technologies. We're using the Mini Educator, the 300 series. We train with a pressure on, pressure off theory. We have a how-to setup guide already online, how to set up your Mini Educator. We've already covered that. We've already established what this dog's working level is, and I've got a video on how to get your dog's working level. I'm going to show you how to do remote collar place. Now, it's important that folks understand that I don't need to use a remote collar so the dog listens to me in this rubber room. Of course the dog will listen to me here. It's a small room, no distractions. The reason why we do remote collar training is because I'm looking for off-leash reliability with high levels of distractions for long periods of time with me close to or far away from my dog. So we're looking for the three D's, but we start it right here. For all of my clients that do one-on-one training, you'll find this very valuable. For all my clients that are picking their dogs up for board and train, you'll find this valuable because you'll know how we train the dog and then you might have to get a refresher once in a while. And for all my fans from around the world, and for all my clients who train their dogs to off-leash capacity, you will find this extremely valuable. Atlas's working level is on a 7. I've set this up that I'll be using continuous. So I've set this up so my black button is momentary, this button, my red button is continuous, and we do not use the T or vibrate button. My theory is pressure on, pressure off. So I'm going to show you how to train your dog, how to do the place command. Good boy. Let's go. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do it with movement. I'm going to walk up to the placemat. When I'm right in front of the placemat, I'm going to say the command place. I'm going to engage the remote, which is pressure. Keep in mind, everyone, that a level 7 is exactly like this. Pressure on, pressure off. Let's go. Pressure on, pressure off. Pressure on, pressure off. Good. Okay. Let's go, Alice. Good. Place. Good. Let's go. Good job. Place. Good. Let's go. Place. Good. Now, teaching moment. Wouldn't that be cool if it was like a little bubble that was right here that said teaching moment, like maybe Jeff's teaching moment, right? Let's come up with that. Jeff's helpful tip. Tips by Jeff. Okay. I'm stopping. I'm doing a bunch of things. I'm using the verbal place command. As soon as I say place, I'm putting pressure on the collar. It's the same pressure as the leash, right? I walk parallel to my dog. As soon as all four paws are on place, I'm letting go of my button, which releases the pressure, and I mark it with good. But I'm doing the magnet steal, magnet steal. Where do I want my dog? I put my body there. So think about that. So if I just stood here and said place, and I expected my dog to go there, we will do that, but that's advanced. I'm sending my dog away. Eventually, I could be over here, my dog can be with me, I can say place, and my dog runs to place. But remember, right now when we teach place, we're in kindergarten. Magnet steel, pressure on, pressure off, put your body where you want your dog, take it really slow, mark good when they're exactly where you want, And my release for this dog right now is, let's go. Good. And I'm holding the remote up in the air. I don't expect you to be holding the remote up in the air when you train. I'm doing this so maybe you'll also be able to see my fingers. Okay? So let's go. Place. Good. Let's go. Place. Good. Good job, buddy. Let's go. Good. Place. Good. Now, do you notice on my break, right after I say let's go, I say it in a higher pitched tone, and I also praise. So, but when I'm doing the commands on some dogs, I'm a little bit flat with my praise. Be really careful. I have a video out there that explains how praise can be good as well as bad. So we really, really want to be careful on when and how we praise our dogs. Good job. Now, place, down, good. Let me show you two advanced place exercises so now you can start working on more advanced skills. It's sending our dog to place slowly, and then also I'm going to walk past place and I don't want my dog to leave place. So what I'm going to do is the first exercise, I'm going to slow down, but I'm going to expect my dog to pass me up. And on one of the exercises, I'm actually going to walk past and I'm going to expect my dog to not walk past. So two exercises, all done with remote collar place. Remember, we're on a level 7, which is a very low level. That's this dog's working level. Let's go. Good job. So what I'm going to do is, it's going to look just like we had prior, but I'm going to, when I slow down and when I say place, I'm still going to be pushing the button, but I'm not going to move. So I'm getting away from magnet steel, and I want the dog to understand when the pressure is on, it doesn't come off till you complete the task. Good job. Ready? Let's go. Place. Good. So what I did was, as soon as I said place, I engaged the button. The dog went ahead of me. As soon as Atlas was fully on place, I disengaged the button because the dog had done the task and I said, good. Marking, that's where I want him. Let's go. Good job. I'll do that again. This time I'll try it from a little bit farther back, because this is how I want you to do it at home. Let's go. Place. Good. Let's go. Place. Good. Let's go. Place. Good. Excellent job. So look at how I gradually got back. I start the first time, magnet steel. The second time, about here. The third, I don't remember the exact same the positioning, but the third and the fourth time. And then eventually, you can even be farther away. So try that at home. But please don't try that right away. Make sure you really work on the dog going to place with the magnet steel concept. Now what I want to do is I want to overshoot it, but I don't want the dog to come off. What I'm going to do is the same concept. I'm going to walk up to it, say place, engage my button, the dog goes on, I will mark it with good, I will disengage my button, I'm going to keep walking. If the dog follows me, I will engage the button anymore, and what I'm looking for the dog to do is go, oops, and I will disengage the button. Let's go. Good job. Let's go. Place. Good. Good. Let's go. Let's go. Place. Good. Excellent. That's why it's so important for your marker when the dog's on place for you to say good. Good actually is a yes, it's a verbal marker, but it also stops the dog. If Alice would have gone onto the ground, I had a couple of options to do. Mandatory, the button goes on. I could have said place again, or I could have said no again. Probably, I usually say at the beginning of training, I say place again. Once that I want them to be proficient in the training, I'll say no. Now, keep in mind, right now, you see the dog is in a really calm state of mind. Remember, being a family dog trainer, I don't want these high energy dogs. I'm looking for the dog to be calm. Atlas came to us pretty pushy, pretty snotty. So what I want him to do is, I want him to be calm. So, because a calm dog can be restful in the house, peaceful in the house, he's not creating nonsense, they're usually not rushing doors. So I'm looking for my family dogs to be calm. Now, when we go outside and play, he's a pretty excited dog. So if we're playing ball, or if we do frisbee, or if we're running around with other dogs, he's a really excited dog. It's important to understand that as a family dog trainer, that we want our dogs, especially indoors, to be calm and relaxed. And a dog that's always on alert, or always excited, or always waiting for the next thing, those dogs are not calm and relaxed. Alice, down. Good. Why do we do place? Place command will allow you to take your dog anywhere, to have anybody over your house. Remember, family dog training, which is what I do, most people don't hire me because they want their dog to be more excited about stuff. I wish my dog was more energized. No, most people want their dogs to be calm. They're really sick and tired of rushing the door, counter surfing, chasing the kids, stealing toys, running up and down the steps, jumping over furniture, fighting with the other dogs, chasing the cat. The laundry list goes on and on. Now, if your dog was doing this, would it be doing any of those things? And the answer is no. It actually wouldn't be doing any of those things. So instead of us constantly saying no and yelling to our dog about everything out there, it's a heck of a lot easier to just train one command to accomplish so many things. All my wonderful one-on-one clients, all my incredibly wonderful board and train clients, and all my fans from around the world who I'm so honored that you're taking the challenge of watching my videos and training your dogs, it's amazing what you do. It is truly amazing. Place command. It's one of the first things we teach dogs. I want my dogs in my house to be calm. That doesn't mean they'll be lazy, doesn't mean they'll be lethargic, doesn't mean they'll be sad. I assure you, these dogs, when it's time to be turned on, they turn on. I'm really big at training dogs to have an on and off switch. It is so important. It's so important. You won't ruin the drive of your dog. The dog won't not like you. Like all those emotional things that we always think that our dog is going to have against us if we have them do this for hours, they won't. How long can a dog do place for? Hours. If you watch television, and you watch 3 hours of shows, your dog should be in place. If you're at the computer with a home office, doing your homework, social media, reading the newspaper, preparation, eating, and cleaning up of family meals, place command is fantastic for that. And you can have multi-dogs in place. Your house is supposed to be a calm environment. This is the number one way to create a calm dog. Now, It's not just, so why doesn't Atlas look all like, woohoo, this is fun work, I love this stuff? Because we've created a calm dog. I take the leash off, we put him outside, party time. Running in the snow, rolling in the snow, playing with his buddies. I don't want that in my house, and I think at least my clients don't want that in their house either. So it's important that we do state of mind training as well. State of mind training, calm on command training. Everybody asks me about calm on command. This is how we get calm on command. One of the secrets. There actually are no secrets. One of the things that help us get calm on command is duration in place. Now, once the dog is doing well with place, we start adding duration work. How long can I keep my dog there? Distraction work. I'll bring out a bunch of different noisemakers and things with wheels and strollers and bouncing balls and electric cars and children running around and maybe other dogs running around. Then what else I'll do is I'll try to start doing distance. Okay? How far can I get away from my dog with them holding command? But listen, don't do them all at once. That's the mistake that a lot of people make. 3 Ds. Duration, distraction, distance. At the beginning, you have none of that stuff. Then you want to add one. I want to be able to add high levels of distraction. You better stay close to your dog. And then you do all your distractions. I want to be able to move away from my dog and create distance. Get rid of the distractions. Slowly move away from your dog. Okay? And then eventually you can add them all together. How to remote collar place command. My name is Jeff Gellman. My company is Solid Canine Training. I'm passionate about doing these how to do-it-yourself videos because I really want you to work with your dog. You can absolutely do this at home. Another thing, if you bring your dog to the office, home office, or your other office, your dog should be in place as well. All right? Madly in love with you. I'm so happy to share, and I'm so happy that you care. I can't wait for my next video to show you. Thank you.